Andrew Ng was the keynote speaker last week on day two of the Snowflake BUILD conference. And in his talk, he shared results of testing different kinds of agentic workflows on the Human Eval benchmark. That benchmark is used to score performance of language models in generating Python code. It consists of prompts that specify various coding tasks at various levels of difficulty. After each submission, unit tests are done and the results are recorded. For Human Eval, the primary scoring metric is pass at K, which measures the probability that at least one of the model's top K samples produced code that achieved the goal as intended. By the way, you might wonder, why is it called a probability? You ran a test. You have a pass-fail result. Did it pass? Yes or no? The reason it's described as a probability is that language models have a random element to them. Definitely, they can generate different outputs for the exact same prompt. So that's why a number of samples are drawn, K samples, as they say, and the pass at K measure looks to see whether at least one of those samples passed the test. So that's why it's called a probability. And it's worth noting that Human Eval is one of the most cited benchmarks for rating performance of language models that write computer code. It's a difficult standard used by OpenAI, DeepMind, and others. For the testing, Andrew Ng tapped on the skills of Joaquin Dominguez and John Santer from DeepLearning AI, the noted education technology company he founded. The team started by benchmarking GPT 3.5, which achieved 48% on the coding benchmark, as you can see here. Next, they tested GPT 4, which achieved 67%, as you can see here. But even the impressive results of GPT-4 were dwarfed by GPT-3.5 itself, provided that the model deployed agentic workflows, as you can see here. The top performing one is this, LDB coupled with reflection. As you can see, it achieved over 95%, which is an amazing performance. LDB stands for Learned Database, which is an agent that acts as a structured knowledge store that gets dynamically updated or queried during various operations. In this context, an LDB can act as a memory-like component that might store things like logs of previous sessions or debugging logs or root cause analysis of failures. So, the agent can learn context-specific information as new data is added. And we saw a reference to reflection there as well. That's a framework that allows an agent to review its actions and decisions and the outcomes of those in order to benefit from trial and error and to improve its performance over time. And so that framework was paired with LDB, which served as the memory component for that. Reflection is described in this paper by Noah Shin and his colleagues at Northeastern University, MIT, and Princeton. In essence, the approach they describe enables reinforcement learning for language agents by providing feedback in the form of words, including helpful context, rather than just a simple pass-fail result. For this, three agents collaborate, an actor, an evaluator, and a self-reflection model that generates actionable feedback. And as we saw, that was the best performing framework that the deep learning team identified for GPT 3.5. Naturally, they also tried various frameworks on GPT-4 as well, which clustered a bit higher than the previous ones, as you can see here. And this time, The top model was AgentCoder, which is a framework that's similar to the one we just saw. Here's the paper that describes that one. As you can see, this was a multinational collaboration effort, and obviously a very successful one. As before, there are three agents that collaborate to generate, test, and refine code. Specifically, a programmer agent that writes the code, and a test design agent that creates comprehensive test cases, plus an agent that does the actual testing, with feedback to the programmer for continuous improvement. Looking at these side by side, you can see how similar they are. Two of the three roles equate, but the third one is different. Specifically, AgentCoder enables continuous testing and refinement, which seems like a pretty nice idea. Of course, other frameworks were tested as well, as you can see. I simply focused on the top-ranked one for each GPT model. And as you can see, AgentCoder and Reflexion were in a dead heat for first place across the two models. Now for convenience, here's a summary of everything Andrew Ng presented last week at Snowflake. Here you can see that Reflexion was the only model that scored a 90+ on GPT 3.5. But in fairness, AgentCoder apparently wasn't tested on that model. Or if it was, the results weren't reported by Andrew at Snowflake. The other framework that achieved a 90+ score was Language Agent Tree Search, which it achieved on GPT-4, but not on GPT 3.5. And, of course, all of these that you see here performed well above the base model performance without agentic design, which is the main point, actually. And so, if you want to advance your own model's coding performance to the head of the class, you now know what Andrew Ng would do. So, that's a pretty good place to start, I'd say. Meanwhile, thanks for watching, and see you next time.